Hi, my name is Rodrigo, and in this video today, I would like to share my thoughts if really the CISSP certification worth it. Of course, this is only my opinion, and I'll be glad to hear from you if you agree, if you don't agree, if you have a different perspective. Today, we're going to be covering about how a CISSP certification can impact your salary, the perspective the others has about you and your possibility and your capability to perform a cybersecurity job. Guys, if you enjoyed this content, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe and activate the notification bell so you don't miss anything in the future. Let's go! Of course, this video can help you to decide if you're going to pursue the certification or not. I'm going to leave on the description of this video a lot of good study resources that I've used to pass my exam. Of course, there is a different video, there are a bunch of videos on this channel, so you can follow all the SSP tips that I've already given, but feel free to access the other videos and follow the playlist as you see fit. But guys, the first and important, very good thing about their certification, and of course this is on a positive side, is that you're gonna be progressing a little bit more faster. The first thing, and super important, is that you're going to remove the very first barrier that you're going to have to be able to do interviews for a cybersecurity role. Of course, when you're dealing about with the HR department, not necessarily they have like a profound, a deep knowledge on cybersecurity. And you as a professional, if you should show to them that you are a CISP certified, or if they are looking for a CISP certified person, your name is gonna pop up. And for them, this is an attestation that you have some knowledge on cybersecurity. Of course, this is not a guarantee that you're gonna get that job, but at least you're gonna be receiving, of course, a lot of more job requests. The recruiters will reach out to you more often. This happened to me and happens with all my other colleagues that passed the certification, because at least this first barrier, the HR, not technical folks looking for cybersecurity professional, you're gonna be removing. So this is a very positive side to take the certification if you want to decide to pursue so. Also on a positive side, and one thing that I find fantastic about the process to take the certification, to pass the certification, is to adapt your mindset, to change your mindset, to think more as a manager. It's like a quote, right? You need to think like a manager to be able to pass the exam. But this is a really good thing. If you want to take your career on this management side, on this management path, this is something that you need to learn. And to be able to go throughout the whole process to study the certification, to be able to pass the exam, you're gonna need to understand that probably you're not gonna answer the questions on a very technical perspective. The exam will not ask you how to configure a firewall, but it's gonna be more how to drive the decision based on cost, impact, effects on that changes, right? So I believe for those who want to pursue this path to change from a technical side to a management side, this is a very positive thing. But if you don't want to go in this path and want to continue on the very technical one, being the very technical, knowledgeable person, there are other certifications that is a better fit for you. So if it's worth it, it's gonna depend on your decision on which path you want to follow. And another positive side also, and this one is very common, if we are talking about especially government positions, or if you are looking for a job in defense, they are very known by always requesting some levels of certifications. They are very strict, not necessarily strict, but well-defined on each level has a specific certification that you need to achieve. So if you are willing to pursue these type of jobs, this is a very good thing, and probably the CISSP worth it for you. But of course, you need to be very careful if those job, that job is more a management perspective, right? A management position. Because if it's a technical, for sure, as I said, they are very well defined on which each certifications they want you to get. And of course, you're gonna lose track of that specific path. So if you are looking for a specific position, government or Department of Defense, for instance, this is a very good, a positive side to take the CISP certification. Not necessarily when you're talking about the private sector, because related to my first point, the private sector did not necessarily request the CISSP for you to get the job. It's more to remove that first barrier that I mentioned, right? To be able to get more interviews. And for sure, you're gonna get a lot of interviews. What it does, it means that you're gonna get that job. And actually, I want now to bring a, not necessarily a positive effect, but a negative side, if I can say the word negative, is that exactly this. Although you're gonna remove the first barrier from the HR to be able to get the interview, we know that the CISP certification, as we call, right, they are super long, but just 1 inch deep. And this is something that you need to be very careful, because we know we need to master the 8 domains. And it's not common, it's not gonna be the case never, that one person needs to, it's going to work with the whole 8 domains in a single position, right? If you're talking about application security, for example, not necessarily you are concerned about the physical security, right? So there are so many different topics, so many different domains, that it's not because you do have the CISP certifications shows that you can apply for every single type of position in cybersecurity. This is a very good point of attention, so be careful about that. But of course, you as a professional, if you decided to take the exam, you're gonna need to be very careful to check the job descriptions, even to check the job descriptions if a recruiter reach out to you. This is super important, right? Because even though this is a possibility, the recruiter cannot know necessarily from a technical perspective, they just saw that you are CISP certified and they reach out to you to see if you are open for new opportunities. So be careful. Do not burn yourself in trying to apply or accept any offer just because you are CISP certified. Make sure that you are capable, you have the knowledge to be able to perform that job well. So it's a very good and important point. You need to understand that you won't know everything. And this can be very controversial, but as I said, I would love to hear your thoughts on that, is that the CISP certification does not make you a better practitioner. It's not because you get certified that you can perform better than those that are not CISP certified. Be careful about this statement also, right? Do not think that it's just because you are certified, you're gonna apply for every single job, you're gonna get that job, your salary is gonna be super high now. It's not the case, right? You're gonna need to show on a daily basis that you are a top performer. And the CISP certification is not going to prove that, right? You need to prove that doing your work as perfect as you can. This is a super important tip. So basically, we have already covered a lot of positives and not so positive sides on considering, right? If you want, or if you need, or if you have to pursue the CISP certification. Of course, there are more good sides than bad sides. And if it's gonna be for me to provide you my suggestion, of course, it's not one size fits all situation. You need to consider your situation. So, but to make things a little bit simpler, of course, there are situations where your company, and it's not normal if you're talking about the private sector, if your company requests you to get the certification for any specific reason, of course, you're gonna take the certification, right? You're gonna need to study. Or if you want, as I mentioned before, if you want to work for a government institution, right? Department of Defense, for instance, This is a good tip, a good first step, of course, if you have the requirements to take the certification. But if you are looking for just to increase your salary, this is not going to happen. And why I'm saying that? The fact that you're gonna get certified and you can get more than 100K per year, it's not necessarily tied to the certification. It's more about you. And this is a good thing, actually, because the process to get certified are tough, right? You're gonna need, of course, depends on how many hours you can spend per day studying. You're gonna take weeks, months studying for that certification. And once you pass, you're gonna need to keep earning your CPEs, right? You're gonna need to pay for the renewal of that certification. So this formal and very good process forces you to keep learning, to keep progressing your career. And this is gonna make you earn more than 100K, for example, a year. It's not necessary you just get a certification, here your good salary. No, it's because you change your mindset. You were able to demonstrate, and now you create the culture in your head to keep studying, to keep progressing, to keep learning new things. And those are the things that your employer, all the organization likes, not necessarily because of the certification. So remove this idea that it's just because you're gonna get certified, you're gonna get your desired salary, is gonna be the impact of you taking the certification, for sure. Because if you pass the certification and keep managing the certification well, you have changed as a person, you have changed as a professional. And this is what are gonna make you earn more money, right? So take this in a positive side and make a good decision for your career about that. Of course, I cannot leave out of this video is that the impression that people is gonna have about you. Everyone that is in the tech industry, not necessarily related to cybersecurity, they know about the certification. In you popping the certification attached to your name, this is a good thing. At least gonna give them the perspective that you are quite knowledgeable about cybersecurity. It's gonna give them confidence for you to discuss with you about any cybersecurity related. But pay attention, right? You're gonna need to make sure that you can discuss about topics that everyone wants to discuss, right? And you taking this certification, again, as I said before, does not show that you have mastered all the topics, that you are knowledgeable enough to discuss deeply about every single domain in the certification. So be attentive, be very careful that you're gonna pass an impression to everyone, but you need to be very transparent. You need to be very real about expectation, things that you can really cover on when you're talking about information security, not talking about cybersecurity. But guys, as I mentioned, those are my thoughts. So should you or should you not take the certification, take all these topics into consideration. Make sure that even the money topic, right? If you can pay for that certification, if it's worth it for you, if the return over the investment is a good fit for you. So make a good decision. Don't rush on that decision. Make sure that you are being smart, right? Because if you are earning your career, probably it's not gonna be a good thing, right? If you are already working, if you have some experience in at least 3-4 domains, and not necessarily you do have a cybersecurity hat, you can apply, you can take this certification to be able to help you to get your first cybersecurity role. But if you are inside your private organization, they are not requesting, you don't want to, on a financial side, you don't want to spend more money, and it's not gonna be bring you benefits for your current situation, probably it's not gonna be a good thing for you to do. But of course, I need to leave to you this decision. I hope this video has opened your mind and helped you to make the better decision for you as a person, as a professional. And as I mentioned at the beginning, I would love to hear a comment below. All the descriptions for all the study resources I placed on the description of this video. I hope you have liked, and see you next week.